We have only few factories in that region that put up the fleets for us. And then the remaining one rely on the local markets. Now, these three companies, because we are the biggest, they are not looking at us as supposed to be. Now, I have a lot of problems in my farm going in water. So when you mentioned they have an anticipated warehouse for storage, I wanted to find out with fruits and vegetables, where can we find some of these warehouses or cold rooms, whereby we can store some of our produce in the maybe later marketing. Thank you very much.
Unfortunately, currently we are doing only staples, so we do maize, soya, sesame, sorghum, and then also do cashew. With fruits and vegetables, you need to have a buyer first who agree that I'm going to pick up your mango on this day at this price. So once that contract is signed and the mangoes are ready, they come and pick them up.
So but you can keep up with other farmers because the source quantity will bring in the dryers and start drying yourself. But if you got the capacity of the dryer, then maybe we should have the number of foods to feed the capacity of the dryer. I also believe any of you has a huge market for the dry foods. So look at your acres, look at the number of tons that mango will give you in terms of mangoes. How many tons per hour dryer do you need? If you don't have the capacity to meet the dryer, think of the other farmers. Then you acquire the dryer, they start drying. There are institutions like PDG, which have to set up a center. They are willing to support institutions like yours through the bank. And I also believe if you are selling to Govan, you are selling to ABW, and you are paying the money to your account, they give an information as to how your capacity. Okay? So if you approach a bank, and you will recommend that if you go to BBG for funding and you look at your turnover, credit turnover, debit turnover, you'll be encouraged to buy a source fund and give you so that you buy that dryer to scale up.
Thank you very much.